Hey kids, well welcome to Millennium Falcon Diorama update number 7. Moving along. And a good day to you. Well, I gotta say, the other day I was talking to a good friend of mine on the phone. He says, my God, it's taking you forever. It's gonna be 4 years before you get this done. And I was like, really? Well, no, it's not, but it's slow going. Some things that you guys may not know about this kit, it has 900 plus pieces, and they're very tiny little buggers. Yes, indeed, they are. And what I did on a portion of the rear end here, I'm about finished up with the top. I did a little bit of filming during the application of some of these little buggers, and I'm going to do you even an accelerated pace, smurfo-fast vision, showing you just how tedious and repetitive and over again of these little pieces, just doing a section of that rear access panel or rear engine panel, of how much time it takes to put on all these pieces. You know, once I get all those little millions of pieces on there, then we get into the detailing phase and all that. That's when I bust out those great big books with all those lovely detail shots of the actual prop and start going to town on the artistic side of this. But we've got to put this puppy together. And I got to say, although the MPC or ATM or whatever it is, MPC kit is nowhere near as good as this, I could have had two of those done by this time. However, we're going quality here, and the Fine Molds kit is obviously a far better kit. And yeah, that's why it costs several hundred dollars as opposed to $34.95. And now what we did do and what we did accomplish is I have managed to cut out those six very, you know, obviously everybody knows about the great big ventilator intake, whatever thing is in the back of the Millennium Falcon where all that black streaking is. And I've used the Paragraphics kits, ventilator openings or whatever the intakes. I have no idea what they are. I mean, it's a starship. I don't know. And we have got a situation here where, like the fiber optic options inside those open, you know, like access panel things where I've added fiber optics, although they don't have to be turned on to keep it canon, when this thing is in the landing bay, those things will have an underglow of blue. And I'm going to put a whole lot of like things underneath that will give the impression of machinery or whatever under there, but only in the landed mode. Of course, when it was in flight, there was no lighting in there, and I'm going to give that option as well. What I'm trying to do is add a lot of eye candy to something that didn't have a lot of eye candy. I mean, if you remember the engine in the back, the blue streak, great. You know, there was a little bit of landing light stuff. The docking thruster or the airlock doors had a little bit of lights, but there wasn't a lot of lighting on the Millennium Falcon. I'm trying to make it look a bit more interesting while it's landed in the Mos Eisley dock and or spaceport, whatever you want to call it. Anyways, so we're going to take a look at what I've done today over the last, I guess, week and a half or so on the Millennium Falcon. Your guys are going to be like, wow, you're slow. Yeah, well, then we're going to take a look at the clip showing you just how tedious and with the tweezers and one at a time. And you also can take into account each part has to be found in this plethora of parts. Each kit part, once it's nibbed off, the tree has to be cleaned, sanded, and prepped. And then, you know, it's a process, man. I mean, just to do a small section can be a whole day thing. And I really can't believe how tedious and long it takes just to get to the part where I want to get, which is getting it all put together, have the lighting functioning successfully, and then go to town and be artistic about it. And that's going to take a while. So, as I predicted, this is a 6-month project right around there. Thank you. What else? I have started something really unique, and I'm trying to not let it take away time from this, however. And, you know, people have tried to engage me in it and all that longer than I want to give it time, which means I've gotten, like, sleep lately. it's called The Smurf Dome, and it's on Facebook. It is an individual group. It is a closed group, by the way. I'm not looking for millions of, you know, members or anything like that. I'm looking for a closed amount of people. There are some rather interesting people there. To drop a couple names, Warren Fahey, the author of Pandemonium and many other books, is a member. John Long, the maker of some very cool kits that I've actually built, and a very interesting fellow who I did not realize had a dark side, is a member. We have about a slightly over 100 members. We're only in our second week now. The Smurf Dome, although it sounds like a silly little happy thing, is not. It's a group, it's a posting group, just like anything on Facebook. People are posting their models and all that. But it's also what's called an immersive, in sort of a cyber society, immersive Dungeons and Dragon thing with satanic overtones. Best way I can put it to you. While you're there and all that, and there's a backstory to it, there's things going on. There's a plot. There's a storyline. And while you're there and you're at your monitor, you're linked to the future. It's after the fall of man. Even after the fall of elves, gnomes, and fairy creatures and all that, the Smurfs are all dead. The Smurf Dome is something in Neo-Vegas in 3245. Whereas the last of the humans have gathered in this dome. And they're kind of like living the life every day on level 40. Let's say there's, a disco dance. Almost like a cruise ship at the end of time. You know, the restaurant at the end of the universe, to quote something. And every morning, or almost every morning, Marvin, who works for the management, which is sort of the unspoken dark beings who live below level 42, which I don't want to give away or anything. Some people have already taken on the persona of the management. Again, it's an immersive sort of thing. If you're really intelligent and you pick up on that and you've played Dungeons and Dragons before, there you can literally be any character you want to be. And some people just haven't picked up on that. They still think that you just run around in the hallways and ghosts try to get you. To add an element of humor and horror, in a way, are something called SVKBs, which, I don't know where I came up with this, who knows. Space Vampire Killer Bunnies. Now, they sound really cute and all that. However, there's an infestation of these things, and they kill. And they kill lots of people. And they're horrific. And there's actually a contest. Whoever can come up with the best plushie Space Vampire Killer Bunny can win $100 or more. And there's a few people that have entered, so we can use that in a future video. The site is privy to its own videos that are not seen anywhere else. It gets the first look at releases from the Kit Factory as far as, for instance, this video will be announced there first, sometimes 12 to 24 hours ahead. They get to see the first pictures of any project by 24 hours. So it's a little incentive for you to join. However, if you're not into adult themed things, for instance, excuse me, guys, picking up a little bit of a cold. Adult language, you can use four-letter words and all that. I wouldn't encourage you to use them overly, although I have a foul mouth, so I use them whenever I feel comfortable doing it, but you don't have to go over it. No porn or anything. Some guy's been posting a couple of pretty girls, and that's fine, but, you know, we're not going for the sexual angle of it. I'm talking about, you know, language is fine, but don't go nuts about it. And basically the Space Vampire Killer Bunnies are the element of doubt. There's also something called temporal police or time police. There's a paradox involved here. While you're on your computer and you're at the Smurf Dome, technically this timeline and 3245, you're connected. And if you walk away from your computer, you have to set your screensaver for 5 minutes because the Space Vampire Killer Bunnies can come through your screen and enter this timeline, which is a temporal paradox. In other words, you've broken the law and the time police will neutralize you, which means that even though you're a member of this group, certain laws have to be obeyed or you are killed, literally killed off the group. So as an experiment, we may just extinguish ourselves into a non-group. It could happen. I'm thinking maybe the popularity of the group will keep it alive. And so far, we've only lost really one member who was an idiot. I'm sorry. Who just really wasn't getting it and kept throwing tangents at the group. Which you have to realize is I am the operator of the game. There are two primes, two guys who kind of keep an eye on things. They're not mods. They're not meant to push you around and tell you, don't do this, don't do that. I don't like that. I never like that about any group. They're actually there to encourage situations to, keep the rhythm of the game going, introduce situations. I mean, you could be posting something and all of a sudden there's an alert that the level you're on has a bunny infestation, you're in danger, it's just interesting. It's just more than posting pictures and waiting for somebody to respond. There's actually action going on. It's something I thought of a long time ago because groups can be quite dull. So I don't really know how to describe it. The game is forming as we speak. Every day, seeing the reactions and posts of people influence the game a certain way. So I have the ultimate end in mind, but it's being formed as we speak. So you have management, space vampire, killer bunnies, you have time police, and other things that are going to come along. You have Marvin, who's the guy who sold his soul and has to run dome control. And then there's videos of him in the morning doing reports. Now there's something new. There's the Dome Freedom Force, which is a terrorist force that is going up against management. Things happen. Things are going. The professor's actually made an appearance there because apparently the professor travels through time. And talking about how some of the people from the Reich went over there. But anyways, again, I don't want to give it so many away. So fun stuff. And a group like no other. So if you're on Facebook and you can handle some weird stuff and strong language doesn't bother you and you're not a big wuss, try it. If people go in and they don't like it, just leave the group. That's fine. But I have high hopes for it being something different, something new. I'm not saying it's going to be the next Warcraft or anything, but it is interesting. And if it doesn't work out, hey, I'll close it. Whatever. Kim Panettone, my good friend, also known as Kim Andrews from the past, has posted a plethora of reference material of the Enterprise from Christie's auction. Oh, my God. There must be 1,000 images of actual prop reference material of all the Enterprise ships. We have a vast library there, and that's something else I wanted to offer. A whole lot of model reference material for modelers. There's some great stuff, funny stuff. So check it out. Like I said, I'm not looking for numbers, vast numbers of members. I am looking for quality members that will make the game interesting. There's also a great video that I'm actually going to show you. Now, I do use VNV Nation's song in there, and I don't know how YouTube's going to react to it being secondhand shown on a screen behind me. If I get a copyright slam, oh well, they'll have a little advertising in there. You guys know I don't put advertising on there, but you see the little banner below, I got slammed. But I do want you to see this, because if I post it directly, I know I'm going to get slammed. Maybe this way, I'll sneak it in, but maybe not. It is the introduction to it. Once you go there, you'll start seeing all the posts, the daily dome reports from Marvin, who's constantly terrorized because he's down there below level 42, presumably in level 50, where management is. And you'll find out who management is. They're down where it's hot. Yeah. And like I said, this game has so many variables and weirdnesses and all that. I'm hoping to see more game happenings than posts, but the posts keep it as basically as a posting forum, but the game enters at strange times, and it goes 24 hours. I mean, literally, I sleep in weird times of the day and night, but I'm there at weird times of the day and night, and so are the primes. So anyways, As we go on, I'll pop the video in probably next, and then we'll go take a look at the Millennium Falcon, and then we've got a really wild film, because the professor apparently is intimate with management, so I've had some very, very talented people working on some films that will also be seen on the Smurf Dome. And I'm not going to say anything about it, but you'll like it. Trust me, you'll like it. Except some people that go to church a lot, they might not like it. So enough of my babbling. Have a lovely weekend. Papa Smurf's hanging in there, and you guys do too. And let's move. And before we go on, I did promise Kim Panettone, formerly Kim Andrews, the lovely lady, my very good friend, who posted and gave us reference material like nobody else's business of Christie's Auctions refit ships and starships and close-ups and, I mean, reference material that people drool over that seek. Thank you, Kim, so very much. And I promise to show your t-shirt. Now, A New Enterprise is one of her personal pet projects. She is trying to recreate, if not CAD, blueprints of and 3D overviews and CAD, you know, twirly-whirly views of the Enterprise refit in every detail, if not an entire new studio class model. She is also running a website that is trying to promote that and all that, A New Enterprise. You can find it on Facebook. She is also a great lady and a good friend, and I love Kim. Kim is like a really close friend. But she put out this company, and honestly, Kim, right now I can't get to the website because I'm in front of the camera, but she sells shirts. And if you go to Kim's website, A New Enterprise, and all that, and start looking into Kim, personal page, Panettone or Pantone. Sorry, Kim. It was Kim Andrews for so long. I don't know if I'm even pronouncing it right. But this is my favorite t-shirt. There's also this great big E one. But right now, I can't find it. I think it's lost in the laundry, Kim, frankly. When I came back from Canada, everything got lost. So I want to slowly close on the camera. I think I've got it lined up right. But this one is Phaser Technology and Targeting Development. And I wore this all around Montreal when I was there. And a lot of people were like, what's that? And it's really cool. So let me close in slowly so people can see the logo. How freaking cool is that? I mean, you don't see people wearing that, everybody. People were like, is that for the military? And I was like, yes, yes, it's top secret. Don't tell anybody. And I love wearing this shirt. And it's really, really nifty. I mean, it's not like something you see every day. You know, it's not like, you know, AC/DC or Guns N' Roses like I usually wear. And I really, really like it. And, you know, what I'm going to do now is like, what I want you to do is I want you to stare at the flashy washy. Good. Now, listen to me very carefully. You're going to go and buy Kim's t-shirts. Hundreds of them, and you're going to not know why. And then when you're done buying hundreds of them, you're going to go back and go, oh, I don't have enough of Kim's t-shirts, and you're going to buy hundreds more, okay? Cool. Excellent. Yes, yes. And now I want to show you what I fought for from the HMO, which was the evil HMO, which wasn't giving me another prosthetic leg. Remember, I have my Star Trek prosthetic leg. And I was saying, well, look, man, every time it gets wet or I do some garden work or whatever, I have to wait weeks to have my prosthetic leg returned to me because it takes time to fix it. And they were like, no, no, we can't do that. So I sent a few happy letters. Look, man, you know, be nice and all that. And they were like, no, no, no. And finally I said, look, man, if you don't do it, I'm going to bring up the fact that my leg got infected. It had to be amputated and your doctor sucked. 2 weeks later, they were like, guess what? Your leg's been approved. So let me show you my new prosthetic leg, which is really, really kind of cool because my wife was asking me, why don't you get like a nice logo on it? Something friendly. And I want to show you what I picked. All right, so you've all seen my Star Trek leg. Well, check this out. I'm a big Punisher fan. And Elliot Brown, my very good friend, did a lot of Punisher hardware comics where he shows all his gear and all that. I had a very good artist in Daytona do this. God, I wish I could remember your name, dude, and I'm so sorry. But check this out. This is a utility leg, which means it doesn't have the Bluetooth and the air pressure system and all that. But this guy, I gave him a Punisher t-shirt because I could not find a t-shirt that would fit the circumference of the leg. And he did just a beautiful job reproducing the Punisher skull in his own style. And this is what I wore. So this is my version of what my wife asked me to get. A friendlier, less menacing thing. So now when I walk in the grocery store, people step away and are looking at me like, oh my God. And oddly enough, the Smurf Dome's icon symbol is a skull. Yes. Cool, huh? So this is a leg that I can wear out back, do gardening, get dirty. It can get wet to a certain point. It can't be submerged or anything. So now I've got the very positive Star Trek ship's leg, which is my high-tech leg, which I can wear for long distances. This one's not so prone to be worn for as long, but it is the more menacing, digging up dirt, tearing up weeds, and doing stuff around the house, Punisher skull. And yes, let me tell you, kids, you kick somebody in the cojones with this thing, and they will turn into a little girl in front of your eyes. Isn't that cool? Great job, by the way. I swear to God, I'm going to come back in the next video and tell you who this guy was. He's right up the street. Daytona Beach is a huge mecca for personalized t-shirts. And I found him, and he's a great artist, and he did an excellent job. He was expensive, but he was good. Anyways, let's move on. Thought I'd throw that in. And Kim, your t-shirts rock, man. They rock. And I programmed their brains. It'll all be good. All right, moving on. Okay, as my dog is munching his meal out there, yes, I actually have other duties in doing this. Let's take a look at the Millennium Falcon's latest results. As you know, I showed you the lighting and all that good stuff so far. Let's take a look over here. Slowly. I'm trying to do this right this time. I hate giving you guys a jerky, right? So, and then I'll show you how I got here so far. I really wanted to get the entire back end done, but it takes such a long time. So here what you're looking at is these thruster intakes or whatever, engine intakes, engine coolant towers, all done with the Paragraphics intakes, and a multitude of little parts. You're probably looking here, my God, I don't know if I counted, I guess close to 100 of them. I started working on this side, this cluster side, and next we'll be moving over here. For every dimple, there's a part or a series of parts. These guys here, underneath, I will be doing either a shadow effect or a cluster of parts with a blue underneath cast of light. It's actually amazing how many parts in this kit. I believe it's 920 something. And if I can do this relatively smoothly, and I haven't been really good with that, over here is what's still left of the parts to come with this kit. And I've been on this for a couple of months now. Still that many. Not to mention all the lighting array that I'm custom making for it. Quite a bit of it. And you know, people are going, you're slow. Well, okay. And what I will do after talking about this is giving you a look at a typical session of doing work on this fella, specifically this area here. And I mean, it's just crazy how much. This area in particular was just crazy. Now, I cannot wait till I've got all these damn little parts on here and I can actually start detailing, because I want to hand detail every one of these little guys and really give it justice. Now, let me pull back a second here, because what I want to do is give you an indication of where I'm going. Once I've got the top and bottom section going here, and you can see, just like one of my starships, the lighting system, although I figured it out, is going distributed all around. And I'm also having to take into account parts that are going to be inserted later, looking at the instructions. I have to leave clearance for certain things. Now, in this area here, where these guys are, I will have to do certain cross projections with allowing with some light to go through to give shadow effects. So when you're looking in, it looks like there's machinery under here. I also have to give enough clearance right here for that rear engine projection system. Now I'm looking to a couple things. I would really like for there to be a rhythm back and forth kind of effect or a flickering effect. I may call Mr. X on that. I'm not sure yet. Again, this is a piece that's being developed slowly. There's a lot of options left to me, but I want this to be a superior piece. And since I have another one on order right now with my very good friend Robert Kennedy, who is a terrific client and a very good friend, actually, I want to learn doing this one so I can do just as good for him when his order comes up. And he's the last order on the schedule, so there's plenty of time to learn. But you can see on this other side here, those Paragraphics grills are terrific. And I can't commend Paragraphics enough for developing this kit, because with the kit, you get these flat top, solid parts, and my God, you would lose so much ability to make this thing so much cooler just using the kit parts. I'm not saying it's a bad look if you're going for the static look, but it's really just not enough for what I'm looking for. So now I'm going to be able to continue. Let's close it on that. With about another, I'd say, my God, there's at least another 100 parts that have to go on here. And I really want to have it all done for you, but it would have gone into next week to do that. And I really, this week was pushing into the 2-week mark, and I promised to do a video every 2 weeks. So you have to believe me that by the time I had this whole area done, it would have been easily Monday. And remember, it's like these guys don't exactly pop in and line up perfectly. They move around. So every part has to be held in place, wait till it locks. Even though I'm using Super T glue, which locks in fairly quickly, there's about anywhere between a 30 to 60 second time lock between the time that I put the part in and then it locks, unless I spray it right away. And sometimes when the part is completely covering the glue, I have to wait. So, counting how many parts there are in that, you're looking at many hours before I start covering the entire area, and the parts are accurate. Sometimes the parts doesn't line up well. Sometimes it instantly welds, and it's not in the correct position. I mean, nobody's perfect, including me, and it takes time to do it right. I believe in delivering something that is good enough for my collection, therefore, it has to be perfect going out the door. Next time you see this particular section, all the parts will be on there, and the intake effect, which will be a light blue coloring underneath, which will have a machinery style masking on top of it. I don't exactly know how I'm going to do it. I have a particular idea for it using some electronic components, but it'll be very, very effective. Again, something you only see in land mode that will not be lit up if the person wants to go with Canon. If the client wants to go Canon, it will not be obvious. But in landed mode, it will definitely have a blue glow. But the blue glow will be partitioned by what appears to be components of the engine. Look, man, you've been eating all my Hot Pockets. I'm not happy with you. You know what happens to Smash that I'm not happy with. I've tolerated it, and I've said, hey, man, if you're cool, I'll give you a Hot Pocket. You've got to work around the lab and do things. Oh man, not again. I've been here before. Shut up. Don't say a freaking word. I'm a good guy, right? Yeah, okay. Hello, Big D. Whoa! Oh, Jesus! Oh, I'm sorry, I swore. I'm so sorry. You never say the J word down here, man. You just never say the J word. What am I doing? No, it's a toy. He's fine. It's just the noise scared him.
Smurf.
Smurfy.
What is that? The gray stuff? No, no. He pooped himself. Yes. Out of his head. Yeah, yeah. And they're different than we are. What can I do for you, Big D? What do you mean? Oh, the Smurf Dome. New thing, man. Don't know much about it. Yeah, I was there once. What do you mean 11 times? Okay, maybe more than once. Yes, yes, yes. The Time Police. I've heard that they're very concerned with time. Okay, man, don't get hot. Don't get angry. Okay, yes, yes, yes. I love what you've done with the place. A little different than last time. Hey, look, there's Goering. What'd you do to him? Oh, his organs are on the outside. Yes, I see. Eh, he doesn't see. He has no eyeballs. Okay, yes? And, I don't know. It's 3245. Yes? Hey, what's with this management thing down there? And that's your boys. I suspected. Yes. You know, those people, they've been through a lot and all that. Oh, they're going through a lot more. Oh, okay. Hey, no problem. Big party, yes. Yes. the Vampire Space Kill Bunnies. I don't know anything about those, man. They're just like, they're really vicious. Can you do anything about them? You didn't do anything with them? There's a couple guys there that said at least one guy said he's in charge of them. He's a liar. Oh, okay. Well, you know. demons, you know, they lie. Oh, no, no. Okay, don't get mad. No, no, no. No, no, it's okay. It's okay. He's a very special kind of demon, I imagine. Yes. Lovely view. Yes, what is that, a volcano? No, oh, yes. It is the souls of a billion people burning forever. Lovely. Very nice, very nice. Yes. Am I going back to this birth dome? Well, maybe sometime. I don't know. I mean, the girls there are very nice. Yes. Desperate and very, very, very nice. Yes. Even a 130-year-old professor is kind of attractive there. Since there's very, very little time left. Yes. What do you want me to do? Keep an eye on the primes. Yes, the primes. Yes, yeah, I haven't heard of the primes. Yes. What else would you like me to do so I stay out of here as long as possible? No, it's great here. It's just I really like my freedom, you know, to be able to go different places. But look, there's Himmler. Yes. Why is his head in his rectum? Because he's a butthead. Oh, it's very funny. Big D, sometimes, you know, you really score it big. Yes. Yes. Me? Oh, no, I'm not up to much. I'm just starting some small little skirmishes here and there, trying to eradicate the world of vermin. How many Smurfs have I killed? Two or three. What's that? Your records indicate almost 10,000? No way. Injured 87,000? No, can't be. No, I don't have that much armament. Satellites, giant tanks. Maybe. I don't know. I've been a busy guy. Yes. Trek Nazi? I don't know where Trek Nazi is. No. What? You're going to totally eradicate me if I can tell you? Okay, he's in the Pisces system, Proxima Centauri, somewhere like that, and he's trying to get his way back here and kill me. Yes, that's where he is. Yes. I love the signs. Very cute. Yeah, people get down here. I'm sure they get the chuckle. And then you throw them in the lake of fire and all that good stuff. Okay. I love the way you change your look and all that. It's very different. Last time you were this big dragon thing, and now you're just this light thing. Okay, that's cool. You ever seen God? He's like this little fuzzy ball. Okay, now, no, I'm sorry. You're the god. Yes, you're the big guy. Okay, well, it's been lovely to see you. Can we talk by phone next time? Because this place, I don't know. You know, when I come here, it's hot, you know, and I'm wearing this coat. No, okay, you'll do whatever the hell you want to do. Pardon the pun. Okay. Well, okay, and I'll see you next time. Auf Wiedersehen. Oh, man. Yeah, he's dead. You know, things went bad when I was in Penham one day. Von Braun said to me, "You've got the touch of evil." Well, hey, I'm out of here. Boys and girls, you have a lovely weekend. And I would consider the damnation of my soul on an eternal scale. Bye now. Oh, man. I need a drink.